Now the commission, and he's brought to you by Skyland Services. And now, let's bring the players.
Well, if we're here in Ashtabin, it's no surprise we see one of the fighters from Ultimate Fighting, or the United Fighter MMA gym in Kenora, Ontario, run by Jesse Bongfeld, and he brings out this time Harold Grun to a fight in the 155-pound weight class, and Harold says he's striking now at another level than it's been before, and he's looking forward to getting in the cage and securing a victory to keep his win streak going, having won his last fight against Miguel Tan.
Well, when you train with Jesse Bonfeld, who has UFC experience, has fought all over the world, you are going to have a very good, well-rounded game. Although Harold believes that his best attribute is his wrestling, able to take people down, and once he's on the ground, able to use that ground game. And again, we talked about that rear naked choke win over Miguel Tan, although he did that by standing rear naked choke in spectacular fashion. But he's expected to come into this fight all prepared, as all of the people out of United Fighter MMA out of Kenora, Ontario are.
Yeah, that standing rear naked choke, much like the one Uriah Faber used at the recent UFC 157 to beat Ivan Menjivar, and that standing rear naked choke got the job done for Harold Grun in his last fight, and we will meet his opponent here shortly.
And his opponent.
So coming down to the cage next, David Dalrymple out of Gracie Baja Chatham in London, Ontario, also home of the 3%ers, as he comes down to the cage and says 1-0, an inverted triangle submission for his only win of his MMA career, and looking to dominate in every aspect here today.
Well, David Dalrymple doesn't want to win fights by decision. He doesn't want to win close fights. He wants to be the one where people say there is no doubt who won this fight. And he won in his first one, inverted triangle, something you don't see very much, a triangle from the top. But you get that position, you're able to lock it in. If you look at the tail of the tape here, very similar stature. One win and 0 for David Dalrymple, and 1-1-1 for Harold Grun. But if you look at David Dalrymple, only training for 2 years, but again, motivated by his older brother, the second fighter we've seen tonight.
Yeah, David Dalrymple, you can see his older brother over his shoulder in the camera shot right now. And the three brothers all live together in one house, and they have matted over their living room, and it's now their jiu-jitsu training area in their home. And he said all they do all day and all night is roll around and work on their jiu-jitsu. So the Dalrymple brothers are getting set here to face off in the Hard Knocks cage.
And now, the official Hard Knocks fighter introductions. In the power darts blue corner, he's 1-1-1 as an amateur, 24 years old, and stands 5 feet, 9 inches tall. He weighed in at 156 pounds, fighting out of United Fighter MMA from Kenora. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Eric Grun. In the Boston Pizza right corner, he's 1-0 as an amateur, 24 years old, and stands 6 feet tall. He weighed in at 154.5 pounds, fighting out of Gracie Baja from London. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, David Dalrymple. This bout will be contended under amateur rules. The referee in charge of the Hard Knocks action is Mr. Elvis Lyon.
Elvis Lyon, our referee. Harold Grun coming out of the blue corner in the blue trunks, the black shorts out of the red corner for David Dalrymple, as these two fighters look to continue the early starting of their amateur main MMA career, and a big punch thrown immediately by Dalrymple after touching gloves and drives him up against the cage.
Yeah, that swing was coming well before the glove touch, so one of those moves is when it works, it will only ever work once, and nobody will ever touch gloves with you again, as David Dalrymple is up against the cage, pushing the heel bone, some foot stomps, something that we saw a lot in MMA probably 4 or 5 years ago, but it's gone out of practice, and David Dalrymple bringing it back.
Dalrymple now being pressed up against the cage by Harold Brunn. Brunn with that one no contest in his career after having an illegal knee delivered by Bob McCumber, unable to continue, so that fight ruled a no contest. But he does have Dalrymple up against the cage right now, and you can see him trying to work that lizard, Jeremy, but not successful so far from David Dalrymple.
And trying to elevate the far arm, and again, I think he should go more to a traditional lizard, able to then switch his hips and get him off, but that's why I am out here, and David Dalrymple in there trying to stop this single leg attack, as you look at Harold Brunn again, needs to try and swing around to the outside to elevate it for the takedown, but maybe content here just to lean on his opponent, try and wear him down.
Brunn was Dalrymple up against the cage, and again, Harold Brunn, the winner of his last fight, secures the takedown here.
Excellent job on the double leg, able to get both his hands underneath the butt of his opponent. It's a natural handle and a natural shelf for an opponent, or for your arms to go there, and it takes away a lot of the gravity. Traditional double legs were put to the knees, the two hands to the back of the knees, but with this new approach underneath the butt, they're realizing it's taking more center of gravity and an easier takedown.
Brunn working from the top, Dalrymple trying to get back to the guard, unable to do so. Notes now, like he's trying to isolate an arm and get a submission hold here. Brunn pulling that hand back and now landing a punch on the far side. But you saw Dalrymple sneaking out the side there and trying to work the submission. Brunn doing a good job on top, holding him down and imposing his will thus far in the first round, Jimmy.
With the submissions like that, you look at Dalrymple, it's very important with the submissions, and he was doing it. He was being very sneaky. He wasn't really pulling on that arm, wasn't torquing on that arm, so perhaps Harold Brunn not necessarily thinking about that arm, and that's when a good jiu-jitsu practitioner will take that advantage, take that arm that's been sitting there lazily, and attack it. And at the end of the round, a bit of a triangle attempt there by David Dalrymple. Tough round to call here in the first one.
Yeah, it did look like Harold Brunn spent most of the first round on top. He'll likely come away with the 10-9 on the judges' scorecards as Coach Jesse Bonfeld comes in to help out his fighter. And on the other side of the cage, David Dalrymple getting more advice from his coach and older brother. Brought him into the jiu-jitsu, brought him into the world of jiu-jitsu a few years ago, and neither of them have looked back since. And we see here on our replay that first punch, and some of the fans displaying their displeasure with that upon seeing the replay, but ducks the hand and comes over with the right. And like you said, Jeremy, it's something that will work once, and we'll see whether or not Harold Brunn puts his hand out for round two. I'm willing to bet no.
Take his odds are minus 600.
So they come out ready to fight immediately this time, and with his hands up was Harold Brunn, and both fighters throwing a couple early exchanges, but nothing big landing until a couple rights. A big right hand there from Dalrymple. Brunn wants nothing to do with that and takes him right down to the ground.
And we're getting some rocky splash here, and a lot of sweat flying off on those landed blows, but there was some shots by Harold Brunn that just glanced off the head of David Dalrymple, but David Dalrymple's shots landed flush and landed clean, so you got to think that Harold Brunn needs to work on the ground here. He can't have another round kicking his opponent down and just being ineffective on the top position. He needs to push the pace here, or the official's going to call him right back standing.
Well, with a minute to go in the first round, Brun secured the takedown. Jeremy got on top, and by the end of that 1 minute, Dalrymple transitioned into a submission. He has 2 minutes to work with here. Will he be able to? And the question is, will he can he secure a submission? Looking for one right here. Brun tucking his arm away to prevent the submission attempt there.
And I think you look in the corner of Harold Brun, I would have seen a lot of these submission attempts as Harold Brun trying to transition out of this position, trying to get into half guard, but David Dalrymple now switching it to a bit of a butterfly. Good pass there by Harold Brun, pushing down the knee and stepping over, now controlling the half guard and trying to land here right up against us.
So Harold Brun continues to be on top of David Dalrymple, lands a nice punch there. Inside, a couple punches now to the face of David Dalrymple, as Harold Brun has really done a good job of controlling this fight while on top here in round number two.
He's also using his head. When you hit an opponent in the head with a punch, the head has somewhere to go. It does damage, but when the head can move, the damage isn't as much. What Harold Brun did is he put his head down and he made a wall. He made a wall so that when he hit David Dalrymple, it would run into his own head, causing more damage on those strikes.
Trying to roll through. Dalrymple now is trying to pop out on the back, but Brun holding that head in. Dalrymple almost out here. More of a side position for Brun as he's trying to pop his head out the back and take the back is David Dalrymple.
Yeah, head and arm position, and that now coming out is David Dalrymple. We'll see what he can do if he can get his head free. He does have the head free now, and coming up is Harold Brun, but a good position by David Dalrymple owning the back. He does have the arm in deep, but chin is down. I don't think Harold Brun will be tapped out to end this round. But a good way to end the round is you're David Dalrymple saying, look, I'm still here. I'm still going to fight you.
Yeah, showing again, I had 2 minutes to transition into, or 1 minute to transition into a submission in the first round. Didn't quite get there. Almost got there. Had 2 minutes to transition into a submission in round number two. Didn't quite get there. Almost got there. So we'll see what he can do here in round number three and whether or not he just tries to go to the ground immediately to give himself the full 3 minutes, Jeremy.
Well, I don't think that will definitely be his strategy, but I think that to be effective here, David Dalrymple has got to use his defense to stop Harold Brun from taking him down and get the better of the striking. We see some of the great strikes that were landed by Dalrymple before the takedown. He left himself exposed as he was continuing to come forward with the wide looping shots, and when he was on the ground, it was all Harold Brun. So if I am the corner of David Dalrymple, I'm saying keep this fight standing. Keep it up. He's going to shoot in. You need to get back. Defend first. Position first. Damage second.
So we go to the third and final round between Harold Brun and David Dalrymple coming out immediately throwing punches. Both fighters, and again, goes right back to the ground with Brun on top.
And he's left himself open, has Dalrymple, and taking him down was Harold Brun. And continuing to lay down. Now, you won't see any elbows. They are illegal here in Estevan. No elbows or knees to the head at any time, whether standing or on the ground. But you see the Harold Brun will just be told by his corner, let's be safe. Let's not fall to any submissions here. Let's try and do some damage and stay busy while we're on the ground.
2 minutes and 20 seconds remaining here in the third and final round. Harold Brun on top of David Dalrymple as these two fighters, and it looks like a triangle attempt here. He hasn't quite got it deep there. Now it's a lot deeper as he got that foot behind the knee. Now he's got to pull the head down and extend, Jim.
Yeah, we'll see where we are here. I don't know whether Harold Brun feels like he's in trouble yet, but he needs to deal with this position before it tightens up, and he needs to stack David Dalrymple, or he's going to end up being in very deep trouble. And the trouble happened when he got an arm to the outside. You must have two hands in or two hands out. That is the ultimate rule for anyone on the top.
So Dalrymple now with the triangle position on Brun, but it doesn't look like he's got it quite locked in yet, Jeremy. And it looks like he's going to try and transition, but there it is! The tap happens! Harold Brun taps out, and David Dalrymple is victorious and hears it from the fans and gives them a little bit back as he gets the tap out victory here to move to 2-0.
Yeah, and I think that's a frustrated Harold Brun sitting there knowing that he could have dealt with that transition a little bit sooner, dealt with that triangle right when it happened, but he was unable to do so. A great job of securing the triangle by David Dalrymple, and he will push his record to 2-0 now, and as a 2-0 fighter, able to secure some of those higher level opponents and try and challenge himself going forward. We're still awaiting the official decision here.
A special shout-out goes to The Mercury, the official newspaper for Hard Knocks Fighting in Esteban.
And again, we talked about that golden rule when you're on the ground. You must always have two arms in or two arms out. You never want to have one arm in. That is where you end up in a lot of trouble. And good of David Dalrymple to realize that that was the position that he had, and he went immediately to that triangle, locked it down tight, and just was patient with it, securing the choke, securing the position. It looks like we do have our official decision, so we are going to throw it up to Jay Ganance.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the official decision brought to you by Skylift Services. At 1 minute and 34 seconds in the third round, the winner by triangle choke in the red corner, David Dalrymple!
David Dalrymple now 2-0. He's with Ryan.
David, we'll get you near the center of the cage. The first round, he takes you down with a minute to go. You almost get the submission. Second round, he takes you down with 2 minutes to go. You almost get the submission. Third round, 3 minutes, he takes you down. And this time, you're able to finish him off.
I thought, Dave, he's a tough opponent. I just want to give a shout-out to Terrell Johnson, my boy Tyson Johnson, my brother Chris Lee Byrne, all my coaches in the corner. Fina, thanks for all the help. My mom, my dad, and J.C. Baja, Brandon Lamb, Matt and Zito, and Joe Batten, and Alex Gasson, too.
Did he ever feel like he had you in a trouble spot in that fight?
Oh, yeah, he was definitely keeping the pressure on me the entire time. I was constantly working. I'm not gonna lie, I was pretty tired at the end of each round. Just throwing stuff up, hoping I get it.
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for your winner, David Dalrymple.